Mariva Valieva, averaging double-double already at this championship for Russia, for 11 and a half rebounds, 22 points on the other side, pardon, and Reza Musina, 11 rebounds, 13.5 points. Such a good young prospect. This is the play caller, Coach Kovalev. We already said he has been an assistant coach for Russia at the Olympics in London 2012. And he knows his team, he knows what they are capable of.
And now, the home team, Team France. I think this might be the deepest French team we have seen in some time. That woman right there has had a great start. Endy Miam, let's not forget Chartreux. And then Sandrine Gruda, who before the game just received her jersey that said 200 games for France. How incredible is her career? Vukosavljevic is playing great, doing what her team needs. The highlight reel, Marine Joannes. Also, the newcomer to the group, Gabby Williams. So when I say this team is deep, this team is really deep, folks. Unfortunately, Olivia Pupa hurt her ankle in the first 2 minutes of the first game. I heard everything is better. We might see her by the end of the tournament. Let's take a quick pause for the national anthem of Russia.
The national anthem of Russia.
And now, the national anthem of France.
And now, the national anthem of France.
And now, the referees for tonight's game. Maj Forsberg from Denmark in the middle. Viola Georgi from Norway. And Maria Ignacio from Cyprus will be calling tonight's action.
We'll see starting five for Russia. Musina, Valieva, Chilova, Komarova, Leuchenka. What to say, quite expected first half. We already mentioned Maria Vadieva, how important that young talent is for Russia, only 22 years old, and that's her fourth Eurobasket. Alongside with Raisa Musina playing for Dynamo Kursk club season, averaging 19 points, 14 rebounds against the Croatia when Russia took that win by 11 points, 73-62. What a great young talent this play corps has. Alexander Kovalev, I already mentioned that he has been assistant coach at the Olympics 2012 for Russian senior team, but what all, he has grabbed a gold in the Basketball World Cup 2017 with his under-19.
And the starting five for France: Endymion, Sandrine Gruda, Valerian Vukosavljevic, Marine Joannes, and Alex Duchesne. Again, we mentioned Ipupa went down with that ankle injury, so she's not gonna play tonight. Sandrine Gruda, the woman who's played 200 games for France, has so far in this tournament been unstoppable. She's averaging 16 points a game, shooting 60% from the field, while also dishing out 2.5 assists. I'm not sure you could really get a much more experienced player than her. Valerie Garnier, the experienced play caller here for France, she's looking to help guide France to their first gold medal at a FIBA Women's Eurobasket since 2009. And I think she has the team to do it this year.
This year's France is really, their roster is full of talent, of legends. I think the combination of youngs and experienced veteran, definitely, if not this year, when else the France gonna go and fight for the gold? The addition of Gabby Williams, small forward, to this roster. You know, Gabby Williams has been crowned as EuroLeague Women Defensive Player last year. You know, the heart would sometimes be missed by French team. I think she could be a great contributor, not only offensively, but mainly defensively for French team. 16 consecutive wins in the Eurobasket group stage, longest active for French team. And this is the 11th game between France and Russia. So these two nations really know each other well, even though it's a different teams. You know, France has won the most recent three after losing five of their first seven encounters. So, yeah, exciting game ahead of us.
Russia has struggled to get out of the preliminary rounds. Can they upset France here tonight and finish first in Group D and advance straight to the quarterfinals? We'll find out. Hello and welcome to the FIBA Women's Eurobasket. Home team France taking on Russia. Two unbeaten teams so far in this tournament. Who's gonna win tonight? Stay tuned, it's gonna be a great one. Vukosavljevic with a quick 2 points for France. Lovchenka finds Shilova. She drives on Mia. Little jump shot off the mark. But Vukosavljevic is there to clean up the boards. Exact same move. She's off, but she gets her own rebound, but can't convert.
It tells you the intention of the French team straight away to attack the inexperienced players of Russia.
Shilova goes all the way for two. Anastasia.
know, we've seen the press conference after the match against the Czech Republic, and Sonny Gruda has said that they know that they have a slow first quarter in the tournament. And she also stated that that's one thing they want to work on into this game and into further stages of the tournament. So let's see if this first quarter is going to be a bit more, you know, in-game than the last two games, first quarter of France. So far, I think so good. We've seen three great penetrations from French players, really showing that they want to play since first minute.
Yeah, Duché doing a good job there, attacking, drawing the foul. She makes her first of two. And the second's good. Great young talent on this Russian team. One of them right there is Musina. She drives, misses an easy layup, but Shilova here gets the steal. Lovchenka open, but no good.
You mentioned Bryza Musina. She had her first double-double at the Women's Women's Eurobasket during her last game against Croatia with 19 points, 14 rebounds.
Andy Miam almost turns it over. Gruda draws the foul. Tough shot, she had to throw it up. Shot clock was winding down. And I believe that foul is on Komarova, number 22 of Russia. She kind of said, what else am I supposed to do?
Well, yeah,
there's nothing. You can't stop Sandrine Gruda.
Absolutely, that smile says that all on her face. And also Coach Kovalev was kind of having smiley face. So yeah, it's just such quality on the French side in Sandrine Gruda's presence.
France up 6-2 after 2 minutes here in the first quarter. Lovchenka, she'll try it from three, and it's good. Vukosavljevic to Joannes, no looks pass to Gruda. She's off the mark, Musina there to pick up the rebound. Shilova, one of the more veteran players, if you can call that, on this team. Joannes falls, somehow gets the ball to Gruda. And Gruda's able to finish in the fast break. Vadieva with her first touch in a scoring position. She draws a foul on Gruda.
Yeah, that's been a great from Russian team. I'm sure Coach Kovalev have already mentioned that this is their great pass off the floor. Assist for Sandrine Gruda. Vadieva needs to get touches. You know that last game against Croatia.
Komarova wide open. Miscommunication there on defense by France. And she's able to knock it down.
Yeah, just to finish the sentence, Vadieva had quite start slow into that, had quite slow start into the game against Croatia. So important she gets touches early in this game.
Joannes is off the mark. But Gruda there to tip it out to Duché. Miam thought about it. Drives, Gruda underneath. Foul call. I think it was a tripping foul. So Gruda going to the line again for 2 points, possible 2 points.
Yeah, and one thing I would like to point out, I think Russia will need to manage their personal fouls if they want to really compete till the end of the game, because that's quite quick, three fouls. And what more, they have sent French teams already on the free throw for the 7 attempts. So that's very much a lot. Considering that there's never defense on those shots. Gruda missed one, so pardon, 6 attempts. 5 out of 6 so far.
Vadieva, good position down low, one-on-one coverage with Gruda, but she misses. Now France running. Nice defense by Komarova. Good job there.
Yeah, Komarova had great game yesterday as well, scoring 12 points for Russia, but not yesterday on the day two. And she's been great contributor from this young roster.
Levchenko. Backdoor to Shilova. Mismatch underneath. You have Vadieva being guarded by Vukosavljevic.
Oh,
but Komarova says, nope, I got it.
Yeah, she has experience from the Russian Premier League, playing for Nadezhda Orenburg last club season. Shooting guard, Elizaveta Komarova.
Gruda, off the mark. Miam fighting for the ball. Musina, backdoor pass is reflected though. So ball is staying, I believe, with Russia.
There's been that penetration of Elizaveta Komarova we've just seen.
Kickball, so shot clock reset. Wide open, Shilova from the corner, and it's a long two. So France giving up a couple points now, a few points, sorry, on a baseline out of bounds by Russia.
Yeah, we've seen in this tournament that the young teams really playing with no fear or anything. And I think so far, these first 5 minutes of the game, Russia plays quite brave and they have nothing to lose. They want to show that they came here to possibly get on the podium. So their goal was to get on the top six, but I think they can achieve way more than that.
And a top six finish puts you in that position to be at the Olympic qualification tournament, which will happen next February. Misura, with a little spin move, but she's off the mark. Rovtenka from deep, her shot's off. Ball out of bounds.
Yeah, and the typical movement for Coach Garnier, which is the early substitutions in a game.
When you have a bench like hers.
Absolutely. But we've seen her doing it even in the bench wasn't as good as this year. But you know what? You gotta get players into the game as soon as it's possible. You might need them in a later stage of the game. So, yeah, nothing new will we see from Coach Garnier.
So Williams checks in alongside Sarah Michelle. Gruda goes strong to the basket. She finds Duché. Duché off the mark. Russia running. Good job getting back on defense there by France. Komarova, her shot's off. I think it's going to be a rebounding foul on Gabby Williams. Good job there by Agun, who just checked in for Russia, crashing the O boards.
Yeah, Russia displaying really good movement on the offensive half these first 7 minutes of the game. They really don't let the defensive players of France rest in any second.
Again, another open shot that Vadieva's off. Michelle, lots of Russian defenders around her. She turns the ball over. Agun gets the ball picked by Sarah Michelle. Duché pulls it back out. Gruda wants it. She's got it. She finds an open Andy Meehan. Andy Meehan's shot is off the mark, but Gabby Williams there to pick up the offensive rebound. Williams to Gruda, Gruda to Sarah Michelle, Sarah Michelle, nothing but net. And France takes the lead.
And that's great. Kick out from Sandrine Gruda to find Michelle. Sarah Michelle open, wide open on that 3-point line.
Komarova wide open, and she started great for this Russian team. 7 points already. No fear from her. Again, this Russian team should actually have zero fear.
Yeah, and you know what? I'm very pleased to see that, because you don't want to see young players to be scared playing. This is your basket woman, and you know, you're competing against the home nation, against someone who's actually really having a target to reach the podium, possibly win the gold medal.
Turnover by France on that possession. They do get back and are able to deflect the ball out of bounds. Yeah, I mean, you know, Vadieva said in the pre-tournament press conference, right? We're tired of losing. We're tired of getting knocked out in the preliminary stages. And when you talk about, there's a quick clip of the 2001 French national team who also won gold. They're here being celebrated at halftime. You know, this is a young team. They don't want to get knocked out. They know that they haven't played well in the recent Eurobasket tournaments. Right now, this is a good test to see where you are and see where you have to be able to compete for a medal at this tournament as well. Chartreux, deep three. It's off. I believe Agoon might have been out of bounds. Great block there by Siak. Really, nowhere to go for Agoon.
Yeah, I'm not sure if you want to go layup right under the hands of Siak, because she's the tallest player on the court at the moment. So you rather want to step back and try to pull up a jump shot or open up your teammate, because obviously she had to help from somewhere.
Chartreux. 2-3 zone here. Nice step through move by Sarah Michelle. She can't score though, but she gets her hand on the ball. Joannes, nope. Goldreva brings it down for Russia. Vadieva has a mismatch.
Oh,
she finds a wide open Glonchi.
And
what great ball movement.
You know what I like in this Russian team is that, considering how inexperienced they are, they really control in their own rhythm of the game. They don't rush, they don't force. They actually just had a break, they stopped it, slow it down, wait for the position, playing very patiently.
So, you said inexperienced, this Russian team. It was Vadieva who made that pass. You want to talk a little bit about her experience? And she's still only, what, 22 years old?
Yeah, she's 22 years old, and that's
Vadieva who made that pass. You want to talk a little bit about her experience? And she's still only, what, 22 years old?
Yeah, she's 22 years old, and that's her fourth women's Eurobasket, the multiple EuroLeague woman champion with a WNBA experience. So, okay, she's not particularly the one I'm talking about unexperienced.
So, but she made this event when she was 16 years old.
Yeah, absolutely. But I have to keep Glonchi. She's one of the ones who's, this championship is the first time for her. And look at that cut, strong cut of us to the rim. Here, French assists, four assists, four turnovers. I like that the Russian team really controls the tempo of what they want to play. And you know what? I think they play a high speed of the basketball. I could see the faces of the French players these first quarter quite heavily breathing, because it's not easy to play against the young team who has loads of energy. And Russia just playing to their reputation of being young, aggressive team.
You know, if it's not this year, I do think Russia basketball is back. I mean, this was a powerhouse of a country in women's basketball. They dropped off the map a little bit, and I think they've done a great job of developing some young talent, and you're seeing how good they are right now. Musina fouls Gabby Williams' jump shot. That's disappointing, because I actually think she had great position. If she had just stood straight up or jumped straight up, it would have been a very, very tough shot for Williams. make or miss, it would have been great defense. But instead, she puts her hand down and draws a foul.
Yeah, and that's her second personal foul. So Coach Kovalev thinks it's better to take her off the court for now so we see back Shilova. No, pardon, Fedorenkova. So you are absolutely right. You play great defense till the last second, and then you are tempted to put that hand down. And it's such a shame because they played hard defense.
Yeah, Gabby Williams able to convert both her free throws. Lead down to just 2 points for Russia. 30 seconds left in this first quarter. Goldreva finds Shilova, great three-point shooter. They get the offensive rebound, though. Goldreva, her shot's good. Look at that, effort on the offensive glass, paid off. Goldreva wide
open
on three.
Not sure they know the shot clock here because there's only 5 seconds left. 2-1. Tough shot by Gabby Williams. Took them a little bit too long to get into that offense. They only had 10 seconds when they inbounded the ball. So after 10 minutes of play here in France, France 14, Russia 19.
Some numbers confirmation, 25% shooting for France from the field. That's not really high percentage for them. 38 for Russia, 17 for France from 3 points to 50 to Russia. That's a huge difference. Obviously, we're still at the beginning. France has made only one out of the six, and Russia has made three out of the six. So only two shots difference, that's not as much. But I think we see in another exciting game where we see the young Russian team really challenging the home nation who has the ambitions to end up on the top of the podium.
Some highlights here from the first quarter. No surprise that woman's in them. Her falling over assist. I agree with you. I think it's right now the turnovers for France and then the shooting percentage. Overall, France are only shooting 3 of 14 compared to 8 of 19 for Russia. Again, this Russian team are just playing fearless, which is great to see because they really have nothing to lose. Win or lose, they've had a great tournament so far. We know they're moving on. It's just which place will they be after tonight's game?
And also, I think they play for their pride because they're showing the new face of the Russian team. So exciting to watch.
Second quarter underway here in Strasbourg, France. Russia up 5. Shilova wide open for 3. Good looking shot. Isn't able to make it, but Shabanova there for the offensive rebound. Glanchi hands it off. Shabanova nowhere to go. Glanchi has to shoot the 3. It's off the rim, but Shilova there diving in for the offensive rebound. 2 offensive rebounds in a row for Russia.
And another one,
but they're not able to take advantage of those offensive rebounds. So now ball back to France. Siak inside, dump off by Gabby Williams, and she draws a foul.
Yeah, we've seen great penetration of Gabby Williams before the Russian defense has been set it up. And that great assist for Siak.
She makes the first of 2. And the second. Her first 2 points of the game.
Shabanova nowhere to go, but she passes off to Fedorenkova. And Joannes fouls Fedorenkova with 4.2 seconds left on the shot clock and really far away from the basket.
You spoke about these fouls, how unnecessarily they are, because you play great defense, all team puts the effort in, and then obviously when the player is not even in the danger position, you just give them the ball and another possession, 14 seconds.
Shilova to Glonchi. Good defense here by France all over Russia. Goldrava nowhere to go. Shot clock winding down. Shilova has to throw it up. Good job by France. And it's a 24-second shot clock violation.
They always say that if you pick up yourself defensively, something in offense is going to come. And that's been great possession from France, really forcing that Russian players into shot clock violation. So let's see what this defensive possession brings them in offense.
So Sarah Michel playing point guard here for France because of the absence of Ipupa. Joannes almost with the offensive tip and she misses. Ball's out of bounds and it's gonna stay with France.
Yeah, Shabanova almost had that rebound. Now baseline position for France.
Williams. Drives, kicks, extra pass to Chartereau, wide open, and 2 points for Chartereau.
Yeah, great ball sharing between the French offensive players. Michel has hit three already, but unselfishly shared the ball.
Shilova kicks it to Glonchi. Her long two is off, and now France are running. Good job getting back on defense by Russia. Michelle drives, tough layup, easy rebound. That's not, you know, she didn't have the opportunity or the angle to pass to Siak. It was Siak's defense who came over. So it's not a bad idea to go up for the layup knowing that you have a rebounder, an offensive rebounder in Siak right there as well.
Yeah, very smart decision. I think the spacing hasn't been even either great for that pass for Siak. So Michel, another experienced player in the French roster. So, yeah, you're absolutely right. Siak, the tallest player in the court. So who else you want to grab your rebound if you miss a shot than her?
Some good minutes here by Siak. She goes 1 of 2 from the line. Goldrava. Komarova, who had the hot hand in the first quarter. Shabanova has to put it up. Her shot's off, but Shilova there to pick up the rebound. Shilova, little jump shot off the mark.
Yeah, that was a good two possessions again from Russian offense, just missing their basket, but great defense from France as well, except for giving up the offensive rebound.
Turnover, Russia running, Shilova tracks it down, is able to save it, but then Shabanova turns it over. Marine Joannes to Sarah Michel. And now France with a 2-point lead. So already 7 offensive rebounds for Russia. Like you said, they've had some really good offensive possessions, giving themselves second chance opportunities with the offensive rebounds. They just haven't been able to convert.
Yeah, on the other hand, we've seen the turnover from Marin Juanes, but then obviously that was a quick return to the defense, and she had chance to steal that ball and run the fast break for Sarah Michelle. So that's how you react to your error. Here's some confirmation offensive rebounds, 8 for France, 7 for Russia. So good effort on the glass from both ends. Second chance point, 7 for France, 3 for Russia. And yeah, that's what we said. They just need to convert it. The effort is great, the high tempo is great. It's just missing those 2 points or 3 points by the end. This is a steal from Juanes and running the break quickly, playing for Sarah Michelle's easy 2 points. And you know, you can make mistakes in basketball, but the important is how you're gonna react to it. You know, if you would have just stayed or played the lax defense, then obviously Coach Garnier would have think about something different. But you know, if you come back and steal the ball, give 2 points, perfect.
Nice take by Gold Reva there.
Yeah, it was a wide open cut towards to the rim. No help from weak defense, from weak side.
Vukosavljevic and Duche, along with Gruda, back in the game. And I believe we have a technical foul for flopping called against Komarova, number 22 of Russia. So Duche shooting the technical shot. Ball will stay with France because they had possession. Rusina checking back in the game. We haven't seen her for a while because she picked up those 2 fouls early.
You see a zone defense right now from this young Russian team. Trying to change the rhythm.
Duche jump shot off Vadieva there.
You know what, it's quite a smart call from Coach Kovalev because he has watched that game, France against Czech, and we've seen that the first half French offense has struggled against his own defense. So a pretty good smart call from Coach Kovalev to try his team to set that zone defense and test the French team today in the game.
Vadieva step through, right hand. She is left-handed, so she's more comfortable going left. Williams kicks it back out. Vukosavljevic, nice little one-handed layup over Vadieva. And she has 4 points in the game.
Great defense from Sandin Gruda. I'm not letting Vadieva to roll after that pick and roll. I think that's, again, smart move from Good Garnier. As soon as Vadieva got on the court, Sandin Gruda got on the court. And it's a great matchup to watch because the experience basically kind of defending another young player. But we know that Vadieva is considered quite experienced already. But great matchup to watch.
Yeah, absolutely. Miam back in for France. Williams nowhere to go. Nice defense there by Russia. Now they're running. Shilova, Vadieva almost is able to come up with the rebound. I don't think that's a bad transition shot by one of your shooters, number 10, Shilova. Yeah.
Shilova, we know that she's a quite good prospect from the arc for Russia.
Gruda misses, but is able to get her own rebound. Again, she misses. Endy Miam there, and then Endy misses. So missed opportunities by the French team.
Yeah, almost like they're playing for the offensive rebound stats.
Rusina goes against Miam, and she can't score. Williams thought about it. Reverse layup. Draws the foul.
Jacob Williams has used that rim and body to protect the ball. That reverse layup. Excellent decision. Adjeva, here we see as she's still shooting 0 out of 3. And that's thanks to great defense of the Sandrine Gruda.
So now France has outscored Russia 11-2 so far in this quarter.
Yeah.
And Russia's still in the game.
Yeah, that's pretty impressive. We have still 4 minutes to go in this quarter, but on the Russian side, they gotta find the offensive weapons, because with the 2 points, they can't think of a good score by the end of this half.
So you just saw Deandra Chachong checking in for Gabby Williams, her first appearance here tonight. Another experienced player for France, Shilova. Vadieva, she has it on the low block. She does have an advantage, misses the layup, almost comes up with her own rebound. Gruda. Good defense there by Russia. Lucina, she has the 2 fouls, remember. Vukosavljevic, she's open for 3, she misses. Ball's tipped out. Komarova turns it over. Duché is fouled by a falling Vadieva, who I think might have got an inadvertent hit to the head. No, sorry, it is Vadieva.
Yeah, that was a great defensive effort from Duché. Look at that, Komarova has thought she's already comfortably overplayed her, but Duché hasn't given up and stole this ball. Great defensive possession for this point guard. Fifth turnover for Russia.
So Russia having trouble scoring in this quarter. They've had good looks.
Yeah, they definitely had great looks, great, let's say, opportunities after the combinations. So what they might need is a quick steal or a quick rebound and try to run some breaks for some easy shots to put them back into the game, scoring-wise.
Mm-hmm. So another missed opportunity for Russia. And ball back to France.
Yeah, I think Coach Kovalev might try to say that the shot has been blocked, but no, it's a French possession.
Mia misses. Ball staying here in the French front court.
Komarova tried to go for that rebound to grab some good defensive one to start to run the break. They know they need to score in this quarter.
Chachong finds Mia. Mia gets her little short corner shot to fall.
Yeah, this short corner shot is so effective against the zone defense because you are behind the last player in the zone. So great recognition from the French offense.
Good denied defense here by Duché. Levchenka. Deep three is off. And now France with an opportunity to push this lead into double digits. Foul. There you see Olivia Ipupa. She has been walking, apparently, doing bike workouts. She suffered an ankle sprain. Testing came back good that she had done the next day. So hopefully she has a speedy recovery and we get to see her play later on in this tournament. We know both these teams, no matter what, win or lose tonight, they are moving on. It just depends who's gonna finish first in Group D, and the advantage of finishing first
means an extra day off. And to be honest, in this heat in here and three games in 4 days, I think it's quite useful. So Valerian Vukosavljevic on the 6 points for a French side, grabbing 5 rebounds. Such a good start, such a good first half of Valerian Vukosavljevic for a French side. Obviously, she's not only contributing point-wise, and you know, the aggressivity to us to the rim from her, that's something that I think France is definitely benefiting of, because even if she misses the shots, there is a rebound, there are the opportunities for the French players to cover that, or she's gonna draw the foul. I think she has been pretty active in today's game.
Enormous free throw differential. 17 out of 19 for France, 0 free throws attempted. I think not just aggressiveness, I think that's also a little bit of experience showing through with that kind of a statistic.
Yeah, it almost feels like the French defenders are pushing Russians away from the basket. You know, they not really going into the contact offensively, because when you try to attack the basket, you gotta get in contact with your defender to be able to even draw the fouls. And I found out that Russians this quarter are finishing quite far away from the rim thanks to that great French defense.
Well, Badieva has 0 points. Musina has 0 points. It's not a good statistic, knowing how much this Russian team needs them to score. Stanko's shot is off. And France, up now, 32-21, with just over 1 minute to play in the first half.
Great assist from Duché. Instead of getting her shot blocked, she's opening up Mia for easy two.
Savchenka. Nice speed on that attack. And that's a good movement. That's a good shot. That's a good speed that Russia needs to have in all of their offensive sets. Duche. Gruda. How many times have we seen Gruda do that move? She's not able to convert. 14 seconds left. Russia should hold it for the last shot. Good job tipping it out of bounds there. France only have two fouls, so they actually have some fouls to give if they want to use them to make sure that Russia doesn't get up an easy shot. 6.6 seconds left here in the second quarter. France up 11 points over Russia, 34-23.
Yeah, and Coach Garnier wants a presence of the tallest player of this game on the court for this last defensive possession for France.
Livchenka, lots of time, but she decides to shoot. Vukosavljevic with the rebound. She's not able to get the shot off. It does not count. Does not count. So here in Strasbourg, France, game day three, group D, home team France with an 11-point lead, 34-23 over Russia. I mean, gonna get a look at some numbers here, but I think for me, the most glaring number is France outscored Russia 20-4 in that quarter. But guess what? They're only down 11. That's not that bad. Go ahead, Teresa.
Yeah, but I think one number stands out in here, and that's the free throws. You know, on the French side, they have taken 19 free throws, scored 17 points out of it, compared to Russian zero. And that's 17 points difference just in that statistic. So, yeah, you just mentioned that Russia is down by 11, considering that they've missed those 17 points in difference in the free throws. Russia needs to get more aggressively, towards to the rim, or get some good stops, run some breaks, but definitely should not be so easily sending the French players to the final line shots, because you know what, you're just giving up the points in that statistic. So it is really one thing what I think Russia will have to improve for the second half. So some scoring leaders, pretty even for France. Everyone's about 5-6 points. No one really standing up in that statistic. On the other side, the same thing. So both teams playing quite team game. You know, whoever steps on, the one's gonna be effective. But we see France only 4 personal fouls for whole team in this first half. That says, you know, it doesn't mean that they don't play aggressive defense. I think they're actually playing really good defense, with Sandrine Gruda leading in that, because she was having the tough task to guard Vadieva. And I think Vadieva hasn't really found a way to play against her offensively yet.
Here's some highlights, first half action for you guys. And you know, I think another stat to me is that 8 players have scored for France. Remember, Ipupa's not playing tonight, so she can't have the opportunity to score. Rupert hasn't played. The only person who haven't scored is Deandra Chatchong. She did a pretty good job going in and playing defense for France. You know, it wasn't really needed. And then on the other side, Russia only have 5 players who have scored. But I think the biggest thing is Musina and Vadieva have not scored. And if you're Russia, I know they're young, but you need those 2 players to at least contribute a little bit if you expect to win, and expect to win against one of the top teams in the world.
Yes, 4 points for the second quarter from a Russian team is definitely not the number what this play caller of Russia, Alex Kovalev will be happy of. I'm sure that will be a big talking point in the changing rooms. And you know what? You're right. France does a great defensive effort on these two because they know without them, it could be easy win for them. On the other hand, obviously, Musina and Badieva needs to be ready that this game's gonna be painful. This game is gonna be needed them so much. So they have to come out way more prepared and way more aggressive to advance to the rim.
Kind of basketball we've become accustomed to watching from Belgium over the past few years.
Oh, driving in, Romanarova gets swatted out of bounds by Vermayenka.
Great timing for Vermayenka there.
She will be thinking twice before she drives in there against Vermayenka.
Duché pushing it. She finds Joannes. Joannes goes baseline, little step back. I'm not really sure what more Burakova could have done defensively. All right.
It is a massive, massive task. It's a mountain. Hildebrandt swatted out of bounds by Indoor.
Upstairs, another top play, please. Block City, get out of here.
Well, start of the second quarter here in Strasbourg, France. Belgium taking on Slovenia. Oh. What a big time block by Linskins.
Look at that.
Oh, that was how far can I hit the ball away. So there you just saw some highlights from game day two, the FIBA Women's Eurobasket. We just saw Sandrine Gruda receive her 200 caps jersey. And now, ladies and gentlemen, coming onto the floor is the team that won in 2001. So 20 years ago, to name some people, Edwige Lawson-Wade, she played with France up until 2013. You'll remember her. Audrey Soiree, Yannick Souvray, who's now in charge of the French Women's League here. Nicole Antibes, Cathy Milan, and of course, Fidzikowski. She was the high scorer up until recently, where Sandrine Gruda passed her to become the top French scorer ever. Some highlights. First half action, France on top of Russia, 34-23.
You could see the highlights of Elizaveta Komarova on the Russian side, 7 points, grabbing 2 rebounds, 2 personal fouls, shooting 100% from the two and 30% from three. On the other side, Valerian Vukosavljevic, great first half. In 12 minutes, 6 points, 50% from two, grabbing 6 rebounds. Here we see the confirmation of my words. You know what, she has been really aggressive towards the rim since first seconds of the game. This is, I think, the action from actually from the first exactly action of the game. And it's nice to see, you already mentioned, contribute. Every player who has been on the court has contributed, either if it was a scoring way or great defensive possessions. So that's the advantage of coach Valerie Garnier, to have such strong roster and strong bench as well.
So again, that picture is of the French national team from 2001,
gold medalists, the FIBA Women's Eurobasket. The coaches, the doctors, a lot of the players here. Katsi Milan is missing, famous French basketball player. So congratulations to those women, coaches, staff. So 20 years ago, they won 2001. Can they win again in 2021?
I think more than ever is this year. And if they're not going to win this year, then I don't know really what to say, because I think Coach Valerie Garnier has done a great job picking such a great roster, ball balance on every aspect. You know, you have a backup players just in case your key players doesn't have a day. They are strong from any position, and when else than this year to be on the top of the podium for France.
Komarova, 7 points. Musina, 6 rebounds. Vadieva, 3 assists. Komarova, 7 points, but all 7 points came in the first quarter.
Yep.
And Musina, Vadieva, 0.
Yeah, that's definitely one of the major points, let's say, of the turnaround from a great first quarter to actually not really as great quarter from a Russian point of view, because scoring only 4 points in one quarter, you can't think to win the game. Here we again see Komarova. I'm sure she's aware of it. She has had a great game on the day two when Russia played Croatia. Komarova has scored 12 points, grabbed 6 rebounds. So this is the statistics from today's game. 7 points, 2 rebounds so far, shooting 100% from two and 30% from three. Yeah, Russia needs small players, but you already mentioned it. Russia needs Musina and Vadieva offensively, not only defensively, but they need to be a contributor with the points.
So the winner of this game will advance directly to the quarterfinals. The loser will finish second in Group D and cross over with the third place team from Group C, and we already know that's Slovenia. Turkey are going home. The Czech Republic are going home. Who's gonna win Group D? Don't go far, because we'll find out.
Valerie Ann Vukosavljevic, 6 points for France, 6 rebounds, 5 defensive. You already mentioned how important that was for her to step like that to the game as she did. Here's some game leaders, 6 points for Vukosavljevic, 6 rebounds for Vukosavljevic, and 4 assists for Marine Joannes. We haven't seen her really contributing for the French team. She has 0 points, but those 4 assists just tells you not only points are important, but also making your teammates better and opening them up is very important in a game of basketball as well.
Mm-hmm. both teams going to the benches. Russia in a little bit of a hole here. Down 11. Had a great first quarter. Couldn't get things going in the second quarter. Let's see what they could do here in this second half coming up.
I think everyone can pretty much hear the crowd we have in here. Finally, spectators are allowed to watch a live basketball. And I tell you, this is a great atmosphere considering that only 50% of the capacity is allowed. Home nation definitely creates a great environment for the national team to play in. This lady, Maria Vadieva, the player who has came to this championship being tired of losing. So can she and Raisa Messina offensively step up for a Russian team in the second half? That's what we will see in a minute.
Welcome back to the FIBA Women's Eurobasket Group D action. France on top, 34 to Russia, 23. Quick pass inside to Gruda. Good defense by Russia. Nice shot by Komarova, and she had the hot hand in the first quarter. So a good start here from Russia. Shona Thorburn alongside Teresa Brantlobad bringing you today's action. Nice hands by Sarah Michelle. They got to get it over half. Vadieva, she's open. But nice tip by Chartereau. Joannes, the third quarter has been her go-to quarter so far in this tournament. She misses though. Vadieva, nice pass from Levchenka. And what a great start by Russia.
Yeah, we can see that Russian came out of that locker room with really intention to run the breaks again, run the floor, because that's what worked for them in the first quarter. Ah, 2 points for Sanin Gruda. Where from the mid-range shot again.
Vadieva, she has it on the low block. Nice defense by Gruda. She's able, Vadieva's able to follow her rebound and I believe tip it off the leg of Gruda. The ball didn't hit the rim though. Yeah, yeah, good job there.
Yeah, again, great defensive possession. We've seen that since first second of this game, how concentrated Sanin Gruda is on that defense of Vadieva.
3.8 seconds to shoot. Vadieva, and a shot clock violation. I actually thought Levchenka was open, maybe just rushed her shot a little bit too much.
Yeah, and Shatterodan this time a great job on Vadieva defensively to push her behind the board so she couldn't really finish that shot.
So Russia, same five starting the third quarter. Joanna's two-point jump shot in and out. So Russia starting the same the third quarter as they started the game. Some changes for France. Chachong. Chechong is in for Vukosavljevic. Sarah Michelle has taken the place of Alex Duché, and Alexia Chartreux is getting the start over Endy Meehan.
Yeah, we have seen that slow-mo of this action which just happened. You know, we have that advantage of having seen replay, and this time I think the call should have been the other way, but possession for Russia.
Musina, oh, her 3 points of the game. French fans not too happy.
Yeah, first 3 points. Actually, first points for Ryzen Musina in this game.
Joannis. A little bit of a late call there by the referee, in my opinion. Again, we do have the advantage of replay. Let's see. It's pretty good defense by Komarova there. You don't want to say makeup call.
Yeah, it's tough because we know that officials could have had a bad angle, couldn't probe it, didn't see it well, or, but as you mentioned, we have the advantage of replay and we can see. What matters is that Joannis' first 2 points of her personally in this game.
Lucina drives hard to the basket.
And this is exactly what you wanted from a Russian team coming out of that locker room, because, you know, we haven't seen them in the first half on that foul line shot. And the aggressivity towards the rim like that from Ryzen Musina is exactly what the Russians need to do. After some movement, be brave and go and drive, because, you know, you can draw fouls, and what more you can get? Some easy shots.
Yeah, I'm sure coach Alexander Kovalev told his team at halftime, guys, they're calling fouls. France has gone to the free throw line 19 times at the halftime. They're gonna call fouls, but the thing is, you have to go aggressive. If you don't go, the aggressive person wins in a basketball game. And if you go aggressive, referees will reward you. If you go up worried of contact, worried of getting blocked, yeah, they're not going to reward you for a kind of play like that.
Yeah, and I think that's what happened for a Russian team in that second quarter, scoring only 4 points, because to be honest, we haven't really seen Russian challenging that French defense. They let them push them away from the rim.
So tough matchup here for number one, who just checked in for Russia, Daria Kurlichuk. Her first few minutes of a game, France notices the mismatch right away and finds Deandra. Easy 2-point basket for Vadieva.
Yeah, I would say that might be the first mistake defensively from the French team, and straight away Vadieva 2 points.
Gruda, her catch and shoot is off. Musina again going aggressive, isn't able to score. But I like this. I appreciate this aggressiveness. Oh. But Noah back on defense. And Chartreux with a 3-point play opportunity.
Yeah, and what else? That's a third personal foul for Ryzen Musina. We will see the replay. Great vision from Sarah Michelle. Great run from Chartreux. Look how your big is running the floor.
You got to reward them, right?
You got to reward him for sure. And now we see an N1. If Shutter will be able to finish this 3-point play, yes.
I think anyone who's played basketball in the guard position knows, if you don't reward your bigs for running the floor hard, they're gonna let you know about it. Vadieva, she misses underneath the basket. Not a lot coming easy for her tonight.
Every single French player who stepped on the floor has contributed point-wise, scored in tonight's game. Great pick-and-roll action from Joannis and Sandrine Gruda.
Levchenka, she has the mismatch.
Musina with Sarah Michelle. Three-point shot is off by Karolinchuk. Good defensive play. And it's going off Sarah Michelle. Oh no, coach. Referee says, my bad. It did go off the leg of the Russian player.
Here we have a replay of the great defense of Lauchenka. And there's great pick and roll. You can see Komarova hasn't been on that split line. But to be honest, you would be quite brave to stand there, Sandrine Gruda, in her way. Vukosavljevic to Gruda. Group A action in Valencia, Spain going on now. Home team Spain taking on Slovakia. Spain with a slight advantage, 39-32.
That's a good ball pressure from France.
It was a good pass. She just wasn't able to hold on to it, Shabanova. And a turnover, Chartreux. Foul call.
The first personal foul, Lauchenka.
Chartreux shot is off the mark. Nice run and finish. Lauchenka to Musina. And Musina, much better job here in the second half. She has 7 points. All 7 points have come in the second half. And the ball is going back to Russia. Vukosavljevic, I think she thinks she got hit. But again, it's one of those areas where you don't want to pick up the ball. You don't want to stop the ball. Right here, you don't want to pick up the ball right over half because... Yeah. The half court line and the sideline are actually defenders.
Yeah, you're almost asking, come to trap me in here because you got a chance.
Komarova drives, kicks, extra pass to Goldreva. Her 3-point shot is good. Great ball movement and aggressiveness and speed by this young Russian team.
It started again with that intention to be aggressive towards the rim, because that's exactly what's going to come out of it. You're either going to draw a foul or open up the teammates when the defensive players are going to react.
Duché to Williams. Williams shots off. Nice action. Siak maybe got away with a foul, but a turnover here. Goldreva picks up the pass. Long 3-point shot by number one, Karolchuk.
Yeah, that has been a quite rush shot, let's say, because they have been on the top of the horse. They have stole the ball twice in a row, and you want to prepare your offense if you can't run the quick break, because you don't want to do a rush shot to give another option for France to run the floor after grabbing a quick rebound.
Duché goes all the way. So the lead back up to 9 for France. 49-40, just over 2 minutes to play in the third quarter. 3-point shot is off. And now a foul, I believe, by Fedorenkova. So Duché is going to go to the free throw line.
Yeah, Russia already on foul trouble assist team, so every foul now
committed on the French players will be rewarded by a free throws again. This is, I believe, 23rd free throw shot for a French team in this game. And on the other hand, we only seen a Russian player to be on the foul line shot only once. And it comes to those last two possessions when the Russian players again settled into those long distance shots, avoiding the contact with the French defense. Right hands from Vukosavljevic to get Goldarenko under the pressure. Here we've seen that hands from Valerian Vukosavljevic. Goldarenko only have an option left to grab the ball and don't let it go easy.
4.2 seconds. Open shot for Federica Kovac. She misses.
Galanti
is there for the offensive rebound and the little jump shot.
This is a ninth offensive rebound for a team of Russia.
Miem to Duche, Siak. Aggressive defense by Shabanova.
Yeah, and that's exactly what you want to see from Bakes to fight for the position, because you're kind of predicting that that ball's going to go in there, so you try to really get in front of your player, or at least some three quarters, to deny the pass.
7 seconds on the shot clock. Duche, Vukosavljevic, her three-point shot is off. Not much to do there other than foul, because Siak had position in front of Shabanova. Look at this.
Yeah, we see that holding of the hand of Siak, so she couldn't lift them up to grab the rebound.
I mean, she had perfect position for an offensive rebound, so she did the work before.
Yeah, at least like this, you know, you're giving a chance that Siak might miss one. So if you lost the position, you gotta stop it some way.
Siak, a pretty good free throw shooter. 4 for 5 now. Well, 4 for 6. Russia. Another 3-point shot attempt is good.
Yep,
for Karolichuk.
But this shot has came out of the movement of the whole five on the court offensively for Russia. So I'm not worried, and that's exactly been paid off.
Oh, great aggressive take by Gabby Williams.
And you know what? We're going to see again a French player on the free throw. It's going to be a 27th. On the other hand, only still once for two shots. So definitely one of the game changer. And France has been quite effective, scoring 24 out of 27.
Gabby Williams with a 3-point play. 30 seconds left in this quarter. France will get the ball back for one last shot. Federkova.
Great defense from French players right now, really putting the pressure on the ball.
So a foul by Andy Miem.
Yeah, France had a foul to give, so we cannot see a sideline possession of Russia. 18 seconds till end of third quarter, 14 on the shot clock.
Federkova, flare screen. And another foul.
That doesn't look too good.
That does not look good. Especially if you heard the scream. So the trainers and doctors are going out now for Russia. This is not a good sign if you're a Russian basketball fan. Both teams are silent and worried. I mean, you never want to see a player go down, even if you're an opponent. So that is number 8 for Russia, Ekaterina Fedorenkova. Hopefully it's not as bad as we think it is. I believe it's her knee.
Yeah, it definitely looked like a knee. I'm sure we're gonna hear about it. You know,
she is hopping off the court with help, though.
Yeah.
Which I think is a good sign sometimes.
Yeah, before this game, Fedorenkova has averaged 10 minutes being
we'll
on the
it.
Court. And in today's game, so far, she had 6.5 minutes, so that's not many minutes this player has played, but yeah, that doesn't look good.
So you see the pain, you see right now her on the bench, her teammates are surrounding her. 3-point shot is good. What a way to finish the quarter for Russia, even though it's not really what they want to see or feel right now, because one of their teammates has gone down with what looks like a knee injury. So at the end of three quarters, France on top, 55-48 over Russia.
Some numbers, France only shooting 9% from three. 8 threes from Russia, 36%. But what's the difference is, how many times have we seen the French player on the free throw line? 27 times compared to only 2 times of the Russian players. You know, now some highlights at the good break from Komarova to Vadieva. But you know what? We only seen Vadieva finish with 4 points so far in this third quarter. I would love to see her back and being really aggressive. But credit to French defense. I think the game plan has been absolutely great from Coach Valerie to put Sandrine Gruda on Vadieva, especially at the beginning of the game when she obviously used experiences to push Vadieva away from the rim where she felt quite confident to finish, and she didn't get any easy shot or any open position, and it, I think, put her a little bit off the game. Just for your confirmation, there's been 22 points difference from the free throw for French team, and we see only 7 points difference in the score. So imagine if Russia has managed better the personal fouls while the French players have been shooting, or if they've been in the team troubles fouls. You know, 22 points is such a big number difference in free throws.
Absolutely. For you to only be down 7 points after going to the free throw line twice and giving up 27 free throw opportunities, it's actually kind of incredible. So France start with the ball for this third quarter, and Nemeam checks back into the game and she gets 2 points quickly.
Yeah, we can't forget to mention that every single French player has scored who has shown up on the court in today's game. What a great team effort.
And there you see a 3-point shot for Russia from number 55, Blanchi. A little frustration shown by Blanchi here. But like you said in the last game, referees doing a good job letting the players not get too frustrated and taking it out on the referees, because again, just like I said last game, I promise you, a referee is not gonna change their mind depending on how you talk to them. Miam. Russia in a 2-3 zone now. Duche to Williams. Back to Duche. Duche for three.
Yeah, that's the second three from Duche in tonight's game. 12 points for the point guard France.
And a quick 3-point shot attempt, but Agun is there to pick up the offensive rebound. Mildreva, Shepanova, nice shot fake. There's a good little up fake there to get Siak off her feet.
Yeah, that's been a great
look
food
at this.
Work.
Yeah.
Not sure if we
tough
haven't
foul
seen.
Foul by Siak.
Yeah, we might seen a little trouble before, but what matters is that Shepanova has been able to kind of use her feet and draw the foul.
Nice hands by Sarah Michelle. She steals the ball. Now France running. Joannes.
Perfect timing, Shona. Perfect timing. She has been a little bit struggling from that distance tonight. So, struggling, let's say, in her standard, because she has hit one out of three in 17 minutes, only 5 points, but six assists. So, you know what? It's actually not bad at all. Giving your teammates six opportunities to score, that's 12 points, her five, but straight away, contribution of 17 points for France from Marion Joannes.
So a good, quick, aggressive start here in the first minute and a half by France. They've come out, outscored Russia 8-3 early in this fourth quarter.
Yeah, six steals for France, 7 points from fast break. Russia seven steals, 2 points from fast break. So this just tells you how effective, or way more effective, the French team is to run the fast breaks and score some easy points. And I think that's one thing what the Russian team would need in this game, to score some easy points. Seems like they really have to work hard always against set it up defense of French team. So some easy points, I'm sure every single Russian player would take them with both hands. So obviously it's also about the way you run the floor. If you get chance to get some easy points here, Marion Joannes, we already mentioned 5.6 assists.
So Russia, after the timeout. Let's see if they can get a score. Shepanova, a little step back, 2-point jump shots off. Agun had pretty good position there for an offensive rebound. Just went over her. Mia. Into, no. She shoots it. Shepanova.
And that was quite a hard pinch, let's say. I know Vuksavjevic is shaking her head, but let's see again.
It was a lot of ball, but that's still a lot of contact on the body.
Yeah.
I know Valeria and Vukosavjevic pretty well. Trust me, she never thinks she fouls.
Great defense from Miam, too.
Great job by France.
Yeah.
Forcing the turnover.
That was a great run around the player from Miam, changing position, basically adjusting based on the ball movement.
Joannes show. Marie Joannes has woken up the fans here in Strasbourg, France, to start this fourth quarter. 8 points for her, six assists on the game.
And the run, 11-3 for France in this fourth quarter. You know, quick threes, you know, it usually mentally really puts teams down. Here we see those hands of Sarah Michel. I think the right hand was all right, but the left hand has been on the Goldareva's back. But two quick threes, it's usually really putting the teams mentally down because the Russia hasn't been really bad so far. We've said that there's been only 7 points difference, but suddenly it came to 15.
Free throw shot missed. Now France with an opportunity to push their lead. Nope, turnover.
Great defense from France.
Yep.
Not letting Russians to create much.
Goldareva with a tough shot. Savjevic finds Gruda. Gruda finds Michel. Michel finds the bottom of the net.
I think, except for Joannes, you have mentioned every single French player who has touched the ball this offense. And this is just a pleasure and joy to watch when everyone gets touches. And obviously, you're always going to find that defense somewhere is going to oversleep.
Agum, tough take. Easy offensive rebound. Shabanova, Goldareva, her three-point shot is off.
Again, we stopped seeing there.
Oh, Andy Miam wide open, miscommunication on the transition defense there by Russia.
Yeah, very much so. I think we haven't really seen again that aggressivity from Russian team to drive and go into the middle of the paint, try to draw the foul and get on the free throw or being able to score. Again, another three from this time from Stanko.
Almost a turnover, but somehow France gets it back and an open layup for Luka Savjevic.
And that's a run of 7 points very quickly. France leading this quarter 18-3, and it sadly reminds me of the second quarter when Russian team has been only able to score 4 points against 20 of the Russia of the France.
So we have seen Vadieva spend more time on the bench, Musina spend more time on the bench than usual. Even Shilova, you know, these are women who, Vadieva averages over 31 minutes.
Yeah.
But do you think he's kind of protecting them maybe a little bit, knowing that they have a game tomorrow?
You know what? I don't really think so, that that's the main purpose of it, because we have seen Vadieva offensively struggle in today's game. And Coach Kovalev had put them on the bench when Russia was down by 7. And I don't think no coach would give up that result with the vision seeing an extra day off at the championship as a reward to the team who's going to finish first in the group. So I don't really think so. I just think, obviously, the French defense does such a great job on them that they haven't put them in the game yet.
Nice backdoor cut by Agum. So a good play call out of the timeout there by Russia. So we do know the winner of this game will finish first. Oh, what a pass by Marine Joannes.
And that's her 7th assist in tonight's game. Just for you to remind the situation from the free throws, 27 free throw shots for France, making 24 out of it, compared to only 4 for Russia.
Vadieva, tough shot. So yeah, the winner of this game gets an extra day off and will finish first in Group D. The loser we will see back here tonight. Nice pass from Niem to Williams. We'll see back here tomorrow night, and we know for sure that they're going to play the team that finished third in Group C, who is going to be, who is Slovenia. Slovenia with a big win today over Bosnia in Group C action. Jump ball situation. Ball is going to stay with Russia, but they only have 3.6 seconds left to shoot.
See a repair on the court for a French side.
Shot clock winding down. I don't think they're aware of the clock. So a shot clock violation. I feel like, you know, not being aware of your shot clock is part of the growing pains when you have a young team.
Yeah, indeed, because the young players usually feel that pressure, you know, of perform on the court, and they sometimes forget on the time.
Gabby Williams finds Joannas. Joannas pass is deflected, and she turns it over.
Yeah, what I mentioned earlier, we see for the first time Rupert on the court for France. It's a player who plays for Bourges Basket in the French top division, and she's recently won the EuroLeague Women Young Player of the Year.
So there in the background, you see the teary-eyed Ekaterina Fedorenkova. We saw her go down just at the end of the third quarter with what looks like a knee injury. We hope it's not that bad, because you never want to see a player get hurt. So hopefully it's not as bad as it looked and as we think. Turnover, Michelle. And an easy 2-point basket for Sarah Michelle.
This is an 11th. Fast break point and 17 from the turnovers of Russia in tonight's game. So pretty efficient. France is really punishing these turnovers.
Sarah Michelle, very good defender, quick hands, long arms. She's not someone you want to casually dribble around in front of for too long. In the last couple possessions, I feel like Russia have fed into the advantage of the France defense. And another turnover for Russia.
Yeah, that's a number 14, and straight away France in the possession to create again.
Gabby Williams.
Jump shot. And this is what is coming out of the turnovers. You know, it's a really efficient team, Team France.
Fedieva, tough shot, gets her own rebound though. She'll pull it back out. Agun drives, pass to Vadieva, a nice little pass, and finish.
Yeah, that just showed us, Agun showed us good court vision. Look at that. Now you're watching great pass for Vadieva. And Vadieva has been able to cut close to the rim just to catch and put it in.
So 1 minute, 30 seconds left here in the fourth quarter. France with the advantage, 81 to 57. France have played everyone on their roster. So have Russia. So both teams playing their benches.
Yeah.
and the France supporters up on their feet. Duché. Joannes to Chartereau, and Chartereau's two-point jump shot is good.
Yeah, wide open shot. We've seen that the Russian defense has collapsed. Tried to kind of catch Joannes, but eighth assist of Marin Joannes.
Joannes maybe trying to get a little too fancy there.
Yeah, great block from Vadiva.
Three-point jump shot. Vadiva there to pick up the rebound. She misses. Agun with a good follow. 17 seconds left in the game. Duché to Rupert. Rupert to Chartereau. Forge teammates. So another 2 points for Chartereau. And that's it, folks. France with the win here over Russia, 85 to 59. They had a couple good quarters. I think this is going to be a great learning experience for a young team. Now they know where they need to be, how they need to play if they want to compete for a medal at a Eurobasket. Keep in mind, this French team should be winning gold at this year's Eurobasket. We already know they're heading to Tokyo. There, number 8, Katerina Fedorenkova. We hope she makes a speedy recovery. So France celebrating. Russia will be back here tomorrow night, and they are gonna take on Slovenia.
Just a confirmation of some numbers. We see that France has improved from threes, hitting 5, shooting 33% from threes. They have shot 51 from twos, but what more I think see the difference is the free throws. We already mentioned it. Here are some top scorers. Duché 12, Komarova 10. We're not used to seeing someone else, Andreza Messina and Vadieva, on the top scorer list than them. But great game from Komarova. We just wished it has been a little bit more consistent and it has been throughout the whole game. But, you know, you're right. We have seen Vadieva and Muzina on the 0 points the whole first half. And, you know, that's something what this young group has to take into another games, that it is very important for Russian team them to be contributors offensively, not only defensively. By the end, Ryza Messina has ended up being on 7 points and 10 rebounds. So great second half, but the game is 40 minutes and you gotta play first and second half to be able to win the games. You know, every single French player has scored today. It just tells you how great this French team is, and that's why this French team is considered to be a top on the podium. So they have such a great roster, balanced and strong on every position. And even though they still had a little bit slower first half, they showed way better first quarter, they still showed better one than the other two games. So that's definitely a positive thing for this French team. They've been aggressive to the rim, having 24 points from the free throws compared to only 2 of Russia.
Some highlights of the second half here. Vadieva, 8 points only,
She had a hard time. Give credit to the good defense. Musina, 7 points. Betty Ava and Musina, all their points were in the second half.
Yeah, indeed. And you know what? The rhythm of the game has been setting during the beginning of the game, during the first half. And we haven't really seen it from these two youngs of a Russian team. So they're going to bring it to the next game that you have to start to play from first minute.
I mean, one positive is when you're looking at the stat sheet after the game, if you're a coach for Russia, you have a young team, you know you're going to have growing pains. 9 out of his 12 players scored. So it means that they can score against one of the best teams in the world, France. So that's definitely a positive. There's so many positives for Russia to take away from this.
Yeah, and you scored against a really good defense as well, because the France has really stacked it up today. Obviously stick to the game plan to cover Vadieva by Sandrine Gruda and really been strong on the glass in the both ends. So yeah, you're right, that is very positive for the Russian coach Alexei Kovalev to know that he can rely on any player of his bench and of his leaders. So we've seen great team effort and we've seen great moments from this young group against this home strong nation. So pretty promising for that tomorrow's game against Slovenia. France is finishing on the top of the group. They will have an extra day off to get some rest, to use that to obviously be ready for the quarterfinals. And here we see Coach Valerie Gardnier really happy, because I think they have beat one of the powerhouses of Russia and advancing into quarterfinals.
So here, game day 3, Group D, France finishes on top, 3-0. Russia 2-1, Croatia with that big win over the Czech Republic today. They're moving on, and the Czech Republic are going home 0-3. So, from Shona Thorburn and Teresa Bruntlova, thanks for joining us, and tune in tomorrow because we have some exciting action coming up at the FIBA Women's EuroBasket.